you. Hey guys, welcome back, and today we're back in my room because today I'm gonna be filming a Q&A, and this is not a vlog. And I normally don't post this much vlogs because normally it's at the stables and I only go twice to the stables for riding. So this is quite new, but today I'm gonna be filming a Q&A. I've been wanting to film this Q&A for a while now. But or I didn't have the time, or I couldn't film it because I needed two phones. One, my phone to read the questions, and two, I need another phone for filming the vlog. And now I am using my mom's phone, and then I'm airdropping all these videos. But today I am finally filming this Q&A. You guys sent a lot of questions, so let's get right into the video. Okay, so I posted a community post like 1 day ago, and there were already 12 people that sent a lot of questions. So yeah, we're gonna see if I can answer them all. First question is, how many setup beds do you own? Now, I think you guys can already guess it, but I own 3 setup beds. I own Hunter Green, they're all from Lemieux, by the way. My first setup bed is Hunter Green. I bought that like in November 2022, and then I own Mist. I bought that last year in March, and I have the full set of that actually. I mean, like, not the full set, but setup bed, base layer, and air bonnet. And I own Kiwi, and that's just the saddle pad and the base layer, and from Hunter Green also the saddle pad and the base layer. So yeah, I own 3 saddle pads. How many ponies have you ridden? Well, I think I have, I don't even know. Like, mainly I'm riding Pebbles now, but in the past I've been to different stables and I rode a lot of different horses, but mainly I'm riding Pebbles now. Dressage or jumping? Jumping, I don't know how to explain it. I do love dressage. I think I would go for jumping, even though it's a really hard choice, because dressage, you need dressage to be able to jump, actually, because dressage is just really important. Well, not really dressage, but more flat work. So I kind of want to say both, but I'm leaning more towards jumping, so I would go with jumping. What's your highest jump? My highest jump is from the 1st of October. I made a vlog about that, and I jumped 1 meter. That's the highest that I jumped. I would like to jump a little higher though, maybe in the future. Maybe me and Pebbles can jump 105, which is quite high. 1 meter is already super high, so I'm still quite surprised that we did that. But I think Pebbles can jump 105, so maybe we're gonna try it this year, but I'm not quite sure if that's gonna happen because it's actually quite high. But yeah, 1 meter is my highest jump. What's your favorite horse gate? Ooh, I think Canter. Canter is just really smooth and just more fast. I love Canter when I'm going on a hack. But I also love Canter when I'm just doing flat work or jumping. Pebbles has a really nice jumping Canter, so I would say Canter. Favorite equestrian sport? God. I really love to watch dressage, but I also love to watch jumping or cross country. But I think, like, I know some, some of the parts of this sport is actually abusive, but I do love watching dressage a lot. It's just so cool to see how elegant all those horses are walking. I would love to ride a horse like that one day. Yeah, it's just really sad that some of the people just use abusive methods. So that's really sad, but I do love watching dressage, so I would say dressage. What's your favorite thing to do with horses? I think riding, but I also love to do liberty or just brushing, cuddling. I I would say everything, but if I can choose two options, I would do writing and cuddling or liberty. It's really hard to choose. I think I would go for writing liberty. That's my two like favorites. Would you rather write for a week or bond for a week? Well, I think you should give your horses a break, at least like 1 or 2 days, because they are horses and they're just like humans, so we wouldn't want to work all week too. So maybe bond. So I think bond means just doing everything on the ground, so liberty, brushing, cuddling, like that stuff. I think you mean that, but my English is too bad to know what that actually means. But I think I would just do bond, because that's actually really important. And yeah, I would go for bond. What is your plans with Pebbles this year? Ooh, well, I'm not the owner of Pebbles, so I can't decide, ooh, I want to go to the beach, or ooh, I want to go to a show. What I can do, my goal for this year is really just to write Techless. And that's a pretty high goal. But we're gonna start soon with necro riding, and if I get like the hang of it, then we're starting to ride bareback, and then we're just combining both. And I would love to do a hack Techless one day. I don't think that's gonna happen this year, but it's a really big goal of mine. As I already accomplished my biggest goal, and that was jumping 1 meter. But that's my new goal, and like for the rest, I think just having fun with my friends, with Pebbles, going on loads of hacks, because I love hacking. Those are my favorite things to do. And yeah, just having fun. I just love to be with my friends, and just having fun with the ponies. And yeah, that's just, I don't know, I don't really have big goals other than riding Techless. But yeah. What is your favorite time of the year? Definitely summer. My confidence is better. We have pony camp. It's warmer, so we can ride in polos and t-shirts. I just love summer. Even though my birthday is in winter and Christmas is in winter, I would just say summer, because like, I wish I was born in the summer, but I'm not. But yeah, I love summer. Like, going to the beach, like, oh, I can't wait to do that again. And yeah, I'm super excited for summer. But yeah, I would choose summer. And if summer didn't exist, I would say spring. Even though, like, I have an allergy, so my skin gets very irritated, and it's now pretty calm. But my skin gets very irritated, and that's super annoying. But I have an allergy, and that makes it a little bit more annoying. So I would say summer, because then it's over. What is your favorite color for you and Pebbles to wear? Definitely mist. I think, like, I have a full set of it, which makes it even more special. But mist suits her so well. And my friend Esther, she's also obsessed with mist, and it suits Pebbles so well. So I would say mist, but I like every color, because I didn't choose the color like just random. I chose the color because I thought it would look great on Pebbles. But I think mist looks the best on her. Let me know what your favorite color on Pebbles is, because I'm very curious what you guys think. How long have you loaned Pebbles for? I started loaning or leasing her on October 1st in 2022. And so like 1.5 years, so I think that. And I met her in June 2022, so I know her almost 2 years, which I'm probably gonna make a vlog about that too, which is in 2 months. I just got a message. Bay or gray? I love grays, but they're getting so dirty so fast, and I would say bay. I've always wanted a bay pony though. Since I was little, I always wanted a pony with like a bay color and a black mane and tail. So I would go with bay, because they're also easier to keep clean, but grays get so dirty easily. Like, Pebbles is not even a gray, she's like a pinto, so she's white and brown. And she gets dirty so easily, and it's pretty annoying. Today she was all covered in sand and mud, so that's actually pretty annoying and really hard to clean. So I would say bae. Do you prefer mares or geldings? Well, I'm kind of a girl that needs a little bit more like action, so I would say mares. But if I do get my own pony, then I ride more, and then you spend a little bit more time with that horse or pony. If I'm allowed to get my own pony, I would do a gelding, because they're a little bit easier. And if I, like, I'm riding Pebbles 2 times a week, so like there's quite some time between that, and that's a little bit easier than you have to ride a mare every day, or almost every day. So I would say mares for loaning, but for owning an own pony, I would say geldings. I wanted to say really quick that I'm used to Pebbles, and Pebbles bucks a lot, and she's a little bit harder than other mares, but she's also a really sweet pony. But it really depends on what kind of mare you're riding, so I wanted to say that real quick. So I just realized I didn't film anything, but those were questions I already answered. How many years have you been riding? I've been riding since 6.5 years. I started riding in August 2017. Yes. And yeah, I'm still riding till this day. I never had a break, so I've been riding 6.5 years. Every week, and well, now this 1.5 years, 2 times a week. So yeah, I've been riding quite a long time now. How tall is Pebbles? Pebbles is 32 or 1.37 meters. I always say it like that so it's easier for people that have a different height in their country. So yeah, that's her height. How old are you? I'm 13. I turned 13 in the end of December, so yeah, I'm a few months 30 now. How long have you been riding? How did you start? Well, I just told you guys how long I've been riding, but I started, like, I always loved horses. I even have a picture of me in 2014 of me with horses, so I always loved them. So my parents wrote, my mum wrote when she was little. You can hear a little bit more of a story in my previous vlog, which she was riding again after quite some time. So if you want to know a bit more about my mom and also a little bit more about my brother, then you should check out that video. But I basically started because of my parents, I think, because my mom rode when she was little and my dad rode a little bit before I was born. So yeah, I think it was kind of like that, and I can't remember that well, but I think I just said to my mom, I want to go horse riding. So yeah, I think I just said that, but I'm not quite sure because it's quite long ago. How long have you been leasing Pebbles? Will you buy him? But it's actually a mare, so it's a she. Well, I already told you guys how long I've been leasing Pebbles, but I don't think I'll ever buy her because I think I'm going to outgrow her. Like, I don't want to say it that loud because it's actually making me pretty sad, but I think I'm going to outgrow her, so buying her wouldn't be the best idea, I think, because then it's even harder to sell her again, and my instructor won't ever allow that, I think, because she loves Pebbles like a lot, so that's, I don't think, an option. Maybe I will get my own pony, but I'm just really like, I don't know what to do with my channel when I outgrow Pebbles, because I can't ride her again and I'm not leasing her again then anymore. So if you guys have any suggestions, then I would really appreciate it, because I just don't know what to do on my channel. Should I make it a different name, like, of my new horse if I get a new loan or an own pony? Or should I just delete it, because then it's not, obviously it's then not me, it's not with Pebbles anymore, and Pebbles is the OG, so like, I would really appreciate some tips. So if you have some of them, please let me know, because I don't know what to do if that is gonna happen. But we're gonna stay positive, guys. We're just gonna think, I'm not gonna outgrow Pebbles, because I don't have to outgrow her. Belle isn't the biggest pony, so I'm always really scared to outgrow her. But yeah, we're just gonna think positive, guys. We're gonna think positive. What's your favorite YouTube influencer? Ooh, I would say Harlow. Her channel is literally amazing. Like, she posts vlogs so much. Her channel is just amazing. And I love watching her vlogs. It's really sad I can't meet her because I am here in the Netherlands, pretty lonely. And she isn't coming to the Netherlands, I suppose. And she's in the UK, so. Okay, last question, guys. I think it's going to be a very short vlog because, yeah, there are a lot of questions. Don't get me wrong, but I think this is going to be quite a short vlog. But now you guys have a Q&A. But last question is, how old is Pebbles? Pebbles is 7 and she's turning 8 in August. So, yeah, she's already turning 8. Like, I started writing her when she was 5. Oh my god. It's actually crazy. So guys, that was today's vlog. And it was quite a short one. Or I think it's going to be quite a short one. But I hope you guys like the Q&A, which I wanted to film for like so long. So you guys finally have the Q&A now. And soon I'm going to be able to buy a GoPro. And I'm going on vacation soon. I'm always hacking at that place. So I hope I have enough money to buy a GoPro soon. So I could just film that hack. Because we're also going to go galloping, which is really exciting. And we have some very exciting news coming up. You guys have to wait a little bit more than a month to see that vlog. But stay tuned because there are coming a lot of exciting things. And I'll see you in the next vlog. Bye!